Yeah.
Thank you, Davis.
Thank you, everyone, for coming and stick around.
Let Earth have worldwide. Yeah. And you're one of them.
We are. We are the lizard people.
Yes. So, how come this? Why did you take this?
First of all, sorry, we don't speak German, so it's obviously all in English. I think we started off with this idea, kind of. True, making independent films is quite hard, and a lot of people go through similar experiences. Projects don't necessarily always get off the ground. So we had a comedy film, couldn't make that because we went to Cannes and we learned in Cannes, you know, you need a big name to make a comedy film. That's one of the things we're so prepared, and we're like, well, that's not gonna happen. Then we turned an action film. That didn't
nearly
work out.
Got that made.
Nearly got that made. We nearly had a nice bit of money for that film, and then just that didn't work out. And we were like, oh, what do we do now? And we were like,
We had a few ideas for horrors,
and we love horror, and we're like, it seems to be one of those genres that people can dabble with lower budgets, and that's it. Kind of grew from there, really.
Yeah.
I think
that's what we did. Yeah. So originally, the film had kind of like indescript monsters or vampires, or, and then through the rewrites, Brian had written. No, I don't blame you. Brian had written a short film before this that had kind of conspiracy theories in it.
Yeah.
So then, building on that, in came the conspiracy theory and the lizard people, and that's where that got inspired from. So just to have a different type of villain that isn't a vampire that people haven't seen that often. So, because we like werewolf films and vampire films, like Dog Soldiers and those films. So
Dusk Till
Dawn.
Yeah, my favorite.
Yeah. And I suppose this is inspired a bit by From Dusk Till Dawn. It starts off as one film and then it switches 30 minutes into something totally different.
Yeah, so thriller turns into a horror, turns into an action, turns into a sci-fi, ends as a thriller. So, have you any questions, David?
I'll ask the audience. Habt ihr Fragen?
How long you shot?
We shot originally for about 20 days, and then we had to do reshoots for, or pickups, for about 5-6 days. So I think in total, it was about 27 days, but some of those days were half days. So we did the initial shoot in the castle for 10 days in one block. That's in Ireland, in Limerick. So that's on the west of the country. And then we shot the rest in the east of the country, in Dublin. And because, again, as Brian said, it's low budget, you're waiting for people to be available. So that kind of pushes out your time and when people are available to do what you need them to do. So. So once we had the edit done, we kind of felt there were some bits we could improve. So the producers said yes, and we were able to go back and redo bits and insert them, and it worked out.
Pretty
better.
Much everything with the monsters we redid.
We redid the monsters.
Yeah. But that those 20 odd days or whatever it was,
yeah,
like that was over a year and a half.
Yeah, like, well, it was actually a year.
Was it?
Yeah, it was exactly a year, because we shot originally in February, and then we did stuff in Dublin, and then we did the reshoots the next February. A year. So yeah, so that was that.
Yeah, I thought it was really, really good. So many twists and turns in that. It was excellent. It really was.
Thank you.
I think that's what we tried to do. Like when you don't have the budget for lots of special effects and all these crazy sequences, we just tried to have the plot just keep doing this as much as possible. Just try and keep you entertained. If it's weird, it's good. Like that's kind of.
What type of, are you allowed to say what type of a budget? Because I'm making a film myself, you see.
It's...
Talk to us in the bar.
Yeah, I don't like it.
But it's everyone kind of worked on, like, we got everyone to work on reduced rates and that kind of thing. But everyone got paid, which is the main thing to us. Like, we had to make sure everyone got paid and things were done properly, insurance, all those types of things.
Yeah,
we couldn't do anything dodgy.
Yeah.
So.
Cool.
Ja, noch eine Frage? Hallo.
The movie was fantastic. You bring it in Europe in the cinemas or direct to Blu-ray and DVD or something like that?
Well, actually at the Berlin Film Market, we had a sales agent. So they've been selling the film to different territories. So at the moment, it's available in Japan. It's available in South Korea. It'll be available in the US, I think before Christmas or in the New Year. The UK in the new year, other parts of Asia, India soon. So it's kind of, it's working its way around at the moment. I'd say within the next 6 months, it'll be done everywhere. But it will be, it depends on what the distributor wants to do in each territory. Like Japan took it and they went straight to Blu-ray and DVD. I think South Korea were doing something different. The US is, they all pick what they want to do, what they feel will be the best for them. No real say in it.
I guess it's kind of one of these interesting learning curves, like when you're making a film, you often don't have much control over what happens to it.
Yeah.
Once it gets sold to a different territory. I hope and I expect we'll get maybe a DVD release in Germany, but probably it won't be a cinema release.
It's very hard to get cinema releases now because you're up against Avengers, you're up against these.
Because I think the movie was very good and it's good enough for a cinema presentation.
Thank you very much. And all the actors are great, but we don't have Robert Downey Jr. in it.
You know something about the distribution in Germany?
Pardon?
You know something about distribution in Germany?
No, I don't know, because basically the sales agent deals with all that. So like as Brian says, our job ended when we handed the film in to the producers, and then the sales agent and the producers kind of take over and they do their thing. Like we have some creative input on say some promotional material and that type of thing, but after that our job is done. So
okay.
We kind of just did this. Like in the new year, it'll be out in the UK and DVD. It's out, as I say, in a few territories already on Blu-ray, DVD, and it'll be coming out in the new year in America on DVD and Blu-ray and the UK as well. So there are a lot.
Nothing for Ireland yet.
We kind of held back Ireland to do ourselves, just because it's a small territory. You just want to see what you can do there, even as a little project to see what we can do. So
to learn more about the industry, I suppose.
To wreck our heads more.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There you go. So.
Okay. Habt ihr noch eine Frage? Hat jeder Stimmzettel?
No questions, sorry. No, I've heard enough about it.
Habt ihr noch eine Frage? Okay, habt ihr auch alle Stimmzettel?
Ja.
Did you vote?
Okay. Yeah.
We
gonna win. Seid ihr für den nächsten Film da? Okay, ja, um halb. Okay. You can sign posters and you can have posters and stuff and everything on the table.
Oh, cool, yeah.
And I would like to make a photo with you.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Great.
Yeah.
And are you staying or leaving?
Oh yeah, we were going to get a drink and then we're going to come back for the film at 11:10 or what time is it?
You mean you're going to miss this one and then the double feature?
I think
we're going to go and have a drink and then come back for the movie. Is that okay?
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I will be here all day tomorrow.
Yeah, we're here.
Okay. Oh, thank you, Brian and Paul.
Thank you very much, David.
Thank you very much.